Hello everyone, welcome to CMI's digital classrooms. Today we are going to learn about the next topic of your class chapter, which is division of integers, right? So till now we have learned about integers. Now we will learn how to divide integers. Okay, so we already aware about that, or we learn in our previous classes that division is the inverse process of multiplication. Means just what happened in division is just opposite of that multiplication. What we used to do for verification, just suppose we are dividing, so we just multiply with the quotient and if remainder is there we add, then we verify that this division is correct, right? So this is how, that means division of a integer is the inverse process of multiplication. Means what? To try to understand that, let's take an example. So divide, suppose it is asking divide 36 by minus 9. So what does it mean? You have to divide 36 by 9 and you have to write the result, right? So what will be the result is, with minus 9 how much we should multiply so that the answer is 36. Okay, so this is asking ki 36 divided by 9 is how much? So that much will be the answer, whatever we should multiply with 9, so that 36. This you can understand from few less numbers. Suppose I am asking you to divide 36 by 9. So what we used to do is, we used to read the table of 9. 9 ka table hum log padte hain and we used to check with how much 9 is equal to 36. Right? So check the table of 9. 4 9 are how much? 4 9 are 36. So that means 4 times 9 is equal to 36. So here it will be 4. Right? And here also it will be 4. Right? So this is the basic thing. This is why it is called that division is the inverse process of multiplication. Right? Here it will be minus. Why it will be minus? Because minus minus, then it will be plus. Okay. And this will be minus. Why this will be minus? Because this is minus. That we will learn about the properties of division. Okay, so first try to understand the basic concept of this. So basic concept of division is that only division is the inverse process of multiplication. Whatever the number you are dividing by, whatever, and whatever the result will come, that will be ki iske saath, with this how much you should multiply so that the answer is coming. Okay, so you can take one more example. Okay, so this one is done. Now suppose I am asking with minus by minus 40 by 8. Okay, so minus 40 you have to divide by 8. So what does it mean is, whatever the answer will come, that will be with 8 how much you should multiply so that the answer is coming minus 40. 8 with 8 how much you should multiply so that the answer will come minus 40, that will be the answer here. Okay, that doesn't mean that you have to do like this, right? I am explaining this to make you understand about the properties. Okay, so this one is done. Now let's take another one more example. Okay, here one more example we are taking. Suppose minus 35 by minus 5. Okay, so if you are dividing by minus 5 to minus 35, then what answer will come? So that whatever the answer will come, that will be when you multiply with 5, then the result will give minus 35. Okay, so this one will be how much? You read the table of 8. 5 8 are minus 40. No, 5 8 are 40. So you have to take minus 5 so that it will be minus 40. Okay, so this will be minus 5. And here how much? 5 7. But here it should be plus because here minus is there. So minus
plus will be minus. Okay. So here 7, that means here also it will be 7. Right. So these are the basic examples through which you can understand the properties which I am going to tell you all now. Okay. Here this is the case when one positive number you are dividing by one negative number, then answer is coming negative number. Here the case is negative number is this bigger number and you are dividing by positive number, then also it is coming negative number. And this case is the positive, both are negative number, so then answer is coming in positive number. So let's say by one both positive number also, suppose 44 divided by 11. Okay, so whatever the result will come, so with 11 when you multiply, then answer will come 44. So then which will be the number 4, so here it will be 4 only. So this is the cases when both the number are positive, then what happens is answer is coming positive. So from this we can conclude that some properties of division, that when any one of the number is negative, either this or this, right? Koi bhi ek number agar negative hota hai, then the result will come in negative one, which is the first property of division. Either this or this, if any one particular number is negative, then the result will come in negative. And another property is, if both the number are positive or negative, means same, if both the number are same, then the answer will come in positive. तो ये केस है जहां पे कोई भी एक नंबर नेगेटिव होता है, तो वहां पे आंसर नेगेटिव में ही होगा. ये केस है जहां पे बोथ द नंबर आर पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव, मींस सेम, यहां पे आंसर हमेशा पॉजिटिव में ही होगा. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द टू प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ डिवीजन. लेट्स डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच इज ऑफ योर एक्सरसाइज. ओके, फ्रॉम योर एक्सरसाइज व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज आस्किंग 80 divided by how much is equal to minus 5. So definitely just opposite of that, with minus 5 how much we should multiply so that the answer is come 80. So if you know the table of 16, then you can understand that 16 multiply 5 is 80. But here most important thing is to understand that if you write only 16, it will be minus 80. But if you are writing minus 16, then it will be 5, 16 are 80 and minus minus it will be plus. So answer will be minus 16 here. Okay. So then only this plus answer will come. If it is minus 80, then only 16 will be there, then it is correct. Okay. Now the next number is 84. Same thing, here it is minus 84. That means whatever you are multiplying, you don't need to multiply by minus of that number, you have to multiply by plus of that number, because minus is already there. So how many times 7 is equal to 84? How many times 7 is equal to 84? Yes, we know 12, 7 are 84. And minus is already here, so minus into plus is minus 1. So this is how it will be, minus 84. Okay. Now, this one is this. How much you should divide by 5 so that answer is come 25. So here definitely you will multiply this. So 25, 5. Question number 3rd. So 25, 5 are 125. 125. But here it is minus, right? So definitely this one also you have to give minus, then only minus minus it will be plus, right? Here we find out that with 7 how much you should multiply, but here we have multiplied. Why we multiply? Because here we have to find out this number. Okay, so that is why 25, 5 are 125, and 125 we have used negative sign so that the result come positive, negative into negative. Okay, minus into minus is plus. So here also will do as like question number third only. 0 into this much is equal to 0. So that means, when you divided 0 by this much, answer will come 0. Okay, very easy. Now this one also you have to multiply this with this. So 1 into 185 is minus 185. Sorry, 186. So minus 186. Then only if you divide by 1, it will be minus 181. If you don't use minus, then it will be wrong. So minus you have to use so that the answer comes in minus. Now this one, 17. We'll multiply. To multiply how much? 17 to our 34. 34, but here answer is in minus, so you will use minus here. Okay. So this is 34. Now this one also 73 one are 73. 73 and here minus sign, so we will use minus sign so that minus and minus it will be plus answer. So here this with minus 1 how much we should multiply so that the answer come 1. So how much? Minus 1, 1 are 1, but minus 1, 1 are not 1. Minus 1 and minus 1 are 1. Why? Because this minus and minus will be plus. So it will be minus 1. So this is how you can do the ratio questions of question number 2 of your exercise 4E. Okay.
Now there are some properties of division. So let's discuss about those properties. Okay. So what the first properties of division is saying? First property of division is saying, in our previous properties of multiplication, addition, or subtraction, we learned that in case of integer, closer properties of integer that multiplication or adding order doesn't matter. We can add anyhow. But here in division, what happens if a and b are the two integer and you are dividing both the number? So it is not necessary that the result is also an integer. So first property is saying, when you are dividing two integer, it is not necessary that the result will also be an integer. Wo integer nahi bhi ho sakta hai. For example, if we are dividing 15 by 4. So 15 by 4, these are the two integers. So do you think any integer will come? No, it will be answer will be 15 by 4, then it will come in decimal. Okay, it will come in decimal. So this is why this is not necessary that when you are dividing any two integers, the result will also be integer. Right? The result may not be integer also, and sometimes it may be integer also. So first property is that. Let's talk about the second property. Second property is of integer is saying, if a is an integer, if suppose there is an integer, but that integer should not be 0. So 0 nahi hona chahiye. So if a is an integer that should not be 0, then a divided by a is equal to 1. A divided by a means what? Any particular number, whenever you are dividing by itself, any particular integer, when you are dividing by that particular integer only, then always the answer will give 1. This is very simple, we already know. Okay. So if you divide 7 by 7, it will come 1. If you are dividing 456 by 456, always it will become 1. Okay. So whatever the integer, in case of negative, suppose negative 47 divided by negative 47, it will also become 1. Okay. So in case of negative or in case of positive, okay. So whenever you are dividing with the same value, same number, then the result will come 1 only. But you need to take care is that the integer should not be 0. Right? A should not be 0. Now, the third property of division of integer is, for suppose a is an integer, okay, and you are dividing by 1, okay. Any integer, whenever you are dividing by 1, then the result is the number itself. So, suppose we are taking an example, 449. If you are
dividing by 1, then always answer will come 449 only. Okay. Suppose minus 723, you are dividing by 1. So what will the answer come? Minus 723 only. Okay. So whenever you are dividing any particular number by 1, I mean any particular integer by 1, then the result will come the integer itself. So this is the third property of division of integers, right? So next property is the property related to the zero. If you are dividing zero by any particular number, always the answer will come zero. But if you are dividing any number by zero, that is not a meaningful. Okay, so there is no any useful of that by dividing zero. Zero means that's it, definitely zero. So if suppose I am taking some example, for example 0 divided by 5. So 0 divided by 5 is 0 only. Suppose 0 divided by minus 3, this will also be 0. But if I am asking 5 divided by 0, then there is no any meaning. So it will be not meaningful. Okay. So this 0 divided by 5 will be 0, 0 divided by minus 3. So if we are dividing 0 by any number, answer will be 0. That is the property of 0. Now suppose any 3 integers are there, more than 2 integers are there, and we have learned about the several properties. For example, A divided by B, first you are dividing this, and then another C is also here, and here A divided by B divided by C. So this type of property also you have learned in multiplication, addition and subtraction also. So here it is not equal. This is not necessary that if you are dividing this A and B first, will be same if you are dividing B and C first. Okay, it may be different. Okay, it may be different. So this is not necessary. This will not be equal. Okay, so this will be vary. For example, you can take, suppose A is 8. Okay, 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. Suppose this is the example you are taking. So first divide A and B. First suppose you divide these two. Then what will the answer? 4, 2 are 8. So 2 divided by 2. Then you can say C, 1 is the answer. Now suppose I am dividing this later, I am dividing this first. So 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. So I am doing now these two first division. So if you are dividing these two first, then see what answer is coming. So 8 divided by 2, 2 are 4. So 2. So 4, 2 are 8, 4. So you can see this is not equal. 1 is not equal to 4. That means it is not necessary, or it will not be equal if you are dividing A and B first, these two number first, and if you are dividing these two number first. So you can see the value are same. Dono ka value same hai. But we have just said that first we have divided here these two, but here first we have divided these two. So in case of division, this rule is not applicable. Okay, this is not equal. Understood? Now suppose 3 numbers are here. The next property is saying, suppose 3 numbers are here, 3 integers are here, but A is greater than B. Maan lo, ye A ka value jo hai, this is greater than B's value. For example, you can take 27 and 18 and 9. Okay, so 27, 18 and 9. So suppose these are the 3 numbers. Okay, you have taken for division. So here what we observe is integer A is greater than B. B se A zyada bada hai. So is samay kya hoga? First case is where A divided by C. A divided by C means this is A, this is B, and this is C we have considered. So A divided by C means this, when you are dividing this, whatever the result will come. How much will be the result come? 3, 9 are 27. right? 3. This result will be greater than B divided by C. So B divided by C means this one. Okay. So we know B divided by C means this 9, 2 are 18. So 2. So you can see 3 is greater than 2. So 3 is greater than 2. That means it is saying this, in this case where 3 integers are there and A is greater than B. So here we have taken 3 integers, 27, 18 and 9, and we can see that 27 is greater and 9 is and 18 and 9 are less. So here first case A divided by C. A divided by C means this. Iska jo result hoga divide karne se 3 ho raha hai, theek hai, 27 divided by 9, and iska jo divide karke result hoga iska 2 ho raha hai. तो ये जो C होगा इसका A के साथ जो डिवाइड करके C का जो रिजल्ट आएगा वो ऑलवेज ग्रेटर होगा इससे A के साथ जो B का डिवाइड करके जो आंसर आएगा. ठीक है. तो दिस इज हाउ 3 इज ग्रेटर देन 2. एंड हियर इफ C इज पॉजिटिव, सो इफ C इज पॉजिटिव मींस दिस नंबर शुड बी पॉजिटिव. सो हियर द आंसर विल कम लाइक दिस 27 बाय 9 एंड 18 बाय 9. सो हियर 27 by 9 and 18 by 9. So 27 by 9 is greater than 18 by 9, right? Now, in the case of second one, A divided by C is less than B divided by C if C is negative. So suppose now we are taking three number again, that those three number only. 27, 18 and 9. Now suppose C is negative. So this is suppose negative number. Then what will happen? Then what will happen C? So if you are dividing this, it will be minus 3. And if you are dividing this, it will be minus 2. So minus 3 and minus 2, we have learned that minus 2 is greater than minus 3. So in this case, if C is negative, so C अगर negative होता है तो ये A का, A को C से जब divide करोगे और B को C से जब divide करोगे तो जो B के, B को C से divide करके जो result आएगा वो result greater होगा. किससे? जिसको जब A को C से divide करके जो result आएगा. ठीक है. So इस तरह से we can conclude that in case of 3 digits, suppose 3 numbers are here, 3 integers are here and A is greater than C, B, A is greater than B, then first case is A divided by C will be greater than B divided by C when C is positive, and when C is negative then it will be A divided by C is less than B divided by C. Okay, so this is the last property, property number 6, very important to understand. Okay, with this I can see you can solve the rest of all questions of exercise chapter 4, exercise 4 especially for E. So your homework will be exercise 4E. Okay, so if you have any kinds of doubt you can ask. Okay, you are welcome to ask. Thank you, have a good time and take care. Bye bye.